If your mind is deeper than your average bozo, knowing what makes you tick will make all the difference. Why is it important to be certain of your correct, true psych types? And why is it important to know the science underpinning psych types? This is as much a philosophical question as it is a practical consideration. Who cares if you have your MBTI wrong, so long as you're happy? It's only another box to fit into. And that four-letter code description sounds just like you, doesn't it? Even if you've only read three others and you've got no idea what those letters really mean, it's just a bit of fun, right? Then there is the I don't care what my real psych type is. Right now I feel like I'm this type. So why is it important to know and understand psych types? How's this for a reason? There is no other information you can discover about yourself that is as powerfully beneficial in understanding any aspect of your life as psych type. When you know your psych type, you can see why you are naturally attracted to some people and activities, but repelled by others. This applies to almost everything you have done or will ever do. From why you were hurt by something said years ago, to why you are attracted or repelled by particular people, to why you prefer different activities, like reading poetry, hang gliding, debating, or computer games. When you have worked with people as long as I have, yes, I know I'm getting very old, you hear a great many stories, some of success, but many of unsatisfied dreams. Most of them have much the same thing in common. People who know themselves and work with what they've got enjoy happier, more successful lives. Okay, I know that success is not so uncommon. We see winners and losers in the news every day. But finding your niche is often as much about luck as it is science. And if you don't believe in luck, I'll share some science. And I'll weave in some examples to explain my convictions. Perhaps the most conspicuous winners are entertainers, who generally know they have the knack of wowing people fairly early in life. But if you can't see yourself making your living in front of the limelight, or if you haven't already got your future mapped out and underway, understanding your psychological gifts can make life's choices so much easier. Perhaps if I put this into context, it'll make more sense. You are researching psych type for a reason. Few people get here by absolute accident. If your mind is deeper than your average bozo, knowing what makes you tick will make all the difference. After all, if you are aware that you have a mind and that you actually think about life, you'll probably also want a relationship and career that befit a more considered sense of self beyond, I wonder what they'd be like. Or, I think I'll try this job for a while. Unlike those who get away with I'll try whatever comes along next, some people know they have a more intellectual purpose that they must define and then find. When a person at, let's say, age 40 or older, with above average IQ, is still trying to find meaning and purpose in life, I am bewildered as they explain their life journey. Why was finding meaning and purpose so hard? One of the most common difficulties I've heard is, I've tried this and I've tried that and now I'm trying something else. And so their story goes on. When I share their psych type and how this might have impacted upon their life experiences, Most people are aghast. So I'm not stupid after all, it's just that I see the world differently to the values of others. I knew it wasn't me, but I felt pressured all along, so I kept doing it that way anyway. In some cases, people maintain that false lifestyle for another 25, 30 years until a breakdown forces them to confront self through therapy or counselling, often starting with discovering their true psyche type. Many people try different partners, jobs and careers. We've all done it. But what's really interesting is that the people who understand and know their value systems seem to know they're in the wrong job or relationship, even how to deal with everyday problems, way before those who don't. I don't mean you wouldn't know that you weren't happy. What I'm trying to share is when you know your own mind, you can express your values without feeling like a sellout or making an ass of yourself. Hopefully, you can also get your message through to the other person without making matters worse. Let's take this a little further into personal relationships. Whether it's people you meet in everyday life or the person you enjoy sharing breakfast with, when you know and can feel proud of your personal value system, it's much easier to accept differences of opinion while calmly advocating your values. This raises two really important points. Firstly, a philosophical consideration. If you know there is some science underpinning the MBTI, why treat it as a curio? Why reference the science if you can't be bothered to learn how and why it works? Or at least consult reputable sources for your information. Does an insight into the nature of self enable a greater understanding of self? And who cares? So why are you researching this stuff? Clearly you want to discover something. Why not be absolutely certain you have only correct information? As I've already noted, people who know themselves always enjoy better lives than those who don't. So any insight into the nature of self should be beneficial. So why do so many people undertake the process of discovering their MBTI, often from one of those crappy online quizzes, then learn a little about it, perhaps again from hopelessly inaccurate sources as many here on YouTube. Then they imagine they have something of value, so they go into teaching others. All the while, ignorant misinformation prevails. Just as the junkie doesn't care what goes into their hit, many here on YouTube are happy to drink from this cocktail of ignorance. If you treat Psyche-Type as a game or a curio, all you get is misinformation and confusion. Now, a practical consideration by way of example. As previously noted, we do a lot of executive development career guidance sessions, workshops. Usually a person comes to us because they have a personal or interpersonal problem which is affecting their career or personal life. You have no idea how many people use Psyche-Type, even though they have it all wrong. For some, despite knowing their MBTI for over 20 years. I remember a 40-something INFJ male who thought he was an ENTJ or maybe an INTJ. You may find that surprising, but it's not at all uncommon. Many male INFJs are aware that they are highly structured in their processes, influenced by their introverted thinking. They type or position themselves as NTJs, never realizing their modus operandi is idealist, nothing like an NTJ, but all the while acting to their detriment. This fellow knew he had been passed over for many jobs, One was a personnel liaison officer in the huge IT company he was already working for. Everyone in the company thought that he would be a perfect fit for the position. But HR wanted a feeling person, not an in-command ENTJ. Because he knew his MBTI, or so he thought, he made sure that everyone else knew it. And he answered all of the psychometric questions as an ENTJ. So the job went to an outside applicant. Though this fellow always knew that he was different to other ENTJs, it never occurred to him that he had both his type and his whole knowledge of psych-type theory totally wrong. He actually got a promotion, only to have problems with several important people in the company. As a coder himself, he got on well with the other coders, but was extremely offended when, during a discussion, some of them sided with another manager who felt his suggested solution would not lead to the best outcome further, suggesting he was being a bit irrational. He had been at the top of his class at school and was awarded his degree, magnum cum laude. He figured as an INTJ, who are these code monkeys and this bean counter, to tell him that he was not rational. He flew off the handle, yelling at the others that he was more structured and rational than any of them. And that was the end of any rank or promotion at that company. This is a great example because many people so totally misunderstand the true nature of their motivation, they then go on to castigate others who are often only trying to help. We call this projection. Often, when people ask for advice on how they can develop their inferior functions, the first thing we discover is that they have been missed type for years, all the while not realizing that they actually need to work on understanding what is really happening in their own head before they start adding new value systems. This is a classic case of knowing the labels, making those labels real, then forgetting who you really are and subsequently making a total mess of your life. Knowing Psyche-Type means that you can choose more compatible professionals in your life, like your doctor, your lawyer, or even someone who you might be doing research with. At the very least, you will be able to connect with people and understand their foibles with the greatest of ease. But you must understand the world through the awareness of your own Psyche-Type filters first. What I have tried to share here is that Psyche-Type is an extremely powerful and beneficial science. Too many people simply don't know their correct Psyche-Type, and many certainly don't know a thing of what they are talking about. Once you accurately know your Psyche-Type, and understand the science underpinning Psyche-Type, you have a distinct advantage in life. This is an area where InterPersonality specialise. You can learn Psyche-Type, the science underpinning your MBTI, discover your true Psyche-Type guaranteed, and spend an hour with a qualified accredited professional for a fraction of the cost of any accreditation course. Now there is no reason not to know your true Psyche-Type, to understand the theory underpinning Psyche-Type, and to have all those niggling questions answered. Learn Psyche-Type. It will change your life.